color of my blood. You're the cure, you're the pain, you're the only thing I wanna touch. Never knew that it could mean so much, so much. You're the fear, I don't care, 'cause I've never been so high. Follow me through the dark, let me take you past the satellite. You can see the world you brought to life, to life. So love me like you do, la la, love me like you do. Love me like you do, la la, love me like you do. Touch me like you do, ta ta, touch me like you do. On the edge of paradise, every inch of your skin is a holy grail I've gotta find. Only you can set my heart on fire, on fire. Yeah, I'll let you set the pace, 'cause I'm not thinking straight. My head's
Don't do it.
Be attentive to our prayers, O Lord, and in your kindness uphold what you have established for the increase of the human race, so that the union you have created may be kept safe by your assistance. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who live and reign with you in unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
Amor tan fuerte como la muerte. Aquí viene mi amado saltando por los montes, retozando por las colinas. Mi amado es como una gacela, es como un venadito que se detiene detrás de nuestra tapia. Espía por las ventanas y mira atrás del enrejado. Mi amado me habla así: levántate, amada mía, hermosa mía, y ven. Paloma mía, que anidas en las hendiduras de las rocas, en las grietas de las peñas escarpadas. Déjame ver tu rostro y haz oír tu voz, porque tu voz es dulce y tu rostro encantador. Mi amado es para mí y yo para mi amado. Grábame con un sello en tu brazo, con un sello en tu corazón, porque es fuerte el amor como la muerte. Es cruel la pasión como el abismo, es centella de fuego, llamarada divina. Las aguas torrenciales no podrán apagar el amor ni anegarlo en los ríos. Palabra de Dios.
Te alabamos, Señor.
Si yo no tengo amor, yo nada soy, Señor. Si yo no tengo amor, yo nada soy, Señor. El amor es comprensivo, el amor es servicial, el amor no tiene envidia, el amor no busca el mal, el amor nunca se irrita, el amor no es descortés, el amor no es egoísta, el amor nunca es doblez. Si yo no tengo amor, yo nada soy, Señor. Si yo no tengo amor, yo nada soy, Señor. El amor disculpa todo, el amor es caridad, no se alegra de lo injusto, solo goza en la verdad. El amor soporta todo, el amor todo lo cree, el amor todo lo espera, el amor es siempre fiel. Si yo no tengo amor,
mayor de los tres es el amor. Hermanos, aspiren a los dones de Dios más excelentes. Voy a mostrarles el camino mejor de todos. Aunque yo hablara las lenguas de los hombres y de los ángeles, si no tengo amor, no soy más que una campana que resuena o unos platillos que aturden. Aunque yo tuviera el don de profecía y penetrara todos los misterios, aunque yo poseyera en grado sublime el don de ciencia y mi fe fuera tan grande como para cambiar de sitios las montañas, si no tengo amor, nada soy. Aunque yo repartiera en limosna todos mis bienes y aunque me dejara quemar vivo, si no tengo amor, de nada me sirve. El amor es comprensivo, el amor es servicial y no tiene envidia. El amor no es presumido ni se envanece, no es grosero ni egoísta, no se irrita ni guarda rencor. No se alegra con la injusticia, sino que goza con la verdad. El amor disculpa sin límites, confía sin límites, espera sin límites, soporta sin límites. El amor dura por siempre. Palabra de Dios.
Te alabamos, Señor. Some Pharisees approached Jesus and tested him, saying, "Is it lawful for a man to divorce his wife for any cause whatever?" He said in reply, "Have you not read that from the beginning the Creator made them male and female and said, 'For this reason a man shall leave his father and mother and be joined to his wife, and the two shall become one flesh?' So they are no longer two, but one flesh. Therefore, what God has joined together, man must not separate." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Evangelica dictelian tu nostra delita. Dear Madeline, dear Kevin, dear brothers and sisters, today we have readings really nice. The first reading is about the Song of Songs, that is talking about the symbolic part of love of a couple. And they are saying words that are poetic. They are talking about the love a man have for a woman. And they're talking in that Song of Songs of the reality of love that is the most important part of life. And we have read in the second reading in the book of the Corinthians, the hymn of charity, where we can see that St. Paul is teaching to us that love is the most important thing in our life. Maybe I can move mountains, but if I don't have love, it won't be important. Maybe I can do many things in my life, but love has to be the central part of my existence. You today are invited to live that love as a couple, to have God in the middle of you, and to have a heart really united one to the other. Today the Gospel is talking about the moment of creation, and Jesus is asked, how can we love? And he said, in the creation, God made man and female. And that moment was important because man and woman were made for love. You were created at the image and likeness of God. You have in the bottom of your heart that characteristic of the love of God. If we think in God, we have to think in a God who is a God of communion, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And we have the image and likeness of God. God put in our hearts that dimension, that is the dimension of love. We understand our life only if we are loving, if we are doing of our existence a life of generosity. So, now in this moment that you're going to say yes for your life, love has to be the center of your existence. You have to love one another. You have to make your hearts united by the love of the Lord. And You have to be one flesh, as we read today in the gospel. That means that you have to be united in love. The word that in the Bible is used to say this union is the word dabach, is a word that is in the original language. That means that you are going to be united and you are going to form one reality, one flesh. Or we can say more than one flesh, one being, because we have body, soul, and spirit. You are going to be united in the love of God. The love you need to have is a love that will make you one person, because the love of God is what's going to be in your heart, and you have to make your life like God. Be one in love, in communion. Love one another. Dearly beloved, you have come together into the house of the church so that in the presence of the church's minister in that community, your intention to enter into marriage may be strengthened by the Lord with a sacred seal. Christ abundantly blesses the love that binds you. Through the special sacrament, he enriches and strengthens those he has already consecrated by holy baptism, that they may be faithful to each other forever and assume all the responsibilities of married life. And so in the presence of the church, I ask you to state your intention. Kevin and Madeline, have you come here to enter into marriage without coercion, freely and wholeheartedly?
Yes, Father.
Yes, Father.
Are you prepared, as you follow the path of marriage, to love and honor each other for as long as you both shall live?
Yes, Father.
Yes, Father.
Are you prepared to accept children lovingly from God and to bring them up according to the law of Christ and the Church?
Yes, Father.
Yes, Father.
Since it is your intention to enter the covenant of holy matrimony, you join your right hands and declare your consent before God and His Church.
I, Kevin, take you, Madeline, to be my wife. I promise to be faithful to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, to love you and to honor you all the days of my life.
I, Kevin.
I, Madeline.
I, Madeline, take you, Kevin, to be my husband. I promise to be faithful to you in good times and in bad, in sickness and in health, to love you, to honor you all the days of my life.
May the Lord, in His kindness, strengthen the consent you have declared before the Church, and graciously bring the fulfillment, His blessing within you. But God has joined together, let no one put asunder.
Amen.
God bless you. You are married. May the Lord bless His rings, which you will give to each other as a sign of love and fidelity.
Madeline, receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity, In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Kevin, receive this ring as a sign of my love and fidelity. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Let us pray for our intentions.
Our responses, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this bride and groom, and for their well-being as a family, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For their relatives and friends, and for all who have assisted this couple, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For young people preparing to enter marriage, and for all whom the Lord is calling to another state in life, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all families throughout the world, and for lasting peace among all people, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For all members of our families who have passed from this world, and for the departed, especially Lita Dora, Rosalba Pacheco. Let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, the holy people of God, and for unity among all Christians, let us pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer.
Recently pour out upon this husband and wife, O Lord, the spirit of your love, to make them one heart and one soul, so that nothing whatever may divide those you have joined, and no harm come to those who have failed, with your blessing, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, Almighty Father.
Amen. The grace of the sacrifice of your hands, the praise and glory of his name.
Receive, we pray, O Lord, the offering made on the occasion of this sealing of the sacred bond of marriage. And just as your goodness is its origin, may your providence guide its course through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you have forget the covenant of marriage as a sweet yoke of harmony, an unbreakable bond of peace, so that the chaste and fruitful love of holy matrimony may serve to increase the children you adopt as your own. By your providence and grace, O Lord, you accomplish the wonder of this twofold design, that while the birth of children bring beauty to the world, their rebirth in baptism gives increase to the church through Christ our Lord. Through him, with the angels and all the saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Oh,
indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, this gift, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like a dewfall, so that they might become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave to his disciples, saying, take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have helped us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Thomas, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, who has pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coerced to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Savior command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope of the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, you said to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy to receive. But only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
Corpus Christi, custodem vitam eternam.
Amen.
Christ.
Amen.
Let us pray. By the power of this sacrifice, O Lord, accompany with your loving favor what is your providence you have instituted, so as to make of one heart in love those who have already joined in this holy union, and replenish with one bread and one chalice, through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Go in the peace of Christ.
No words I could put on the back of a postcard, no song that I could sing, but I can try for your heart. And our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions in my heart, like why are we here and where do we go, and knock on me so hard. And it's not always easy, and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together. It's always better when we're together. Yeah, we'll look at them stars when we're together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together.
Our family wedding this year, and there are those hands, that's husband and wife.
There's no combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard, no song that I could sing, but I can try for your heart. Our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, at least for most of the questions in my heart, like why are we here and where do we go, and knock on me so hard. And it's not always easy, and sometimes life can be deceiving. I'll tell you one thing, it's always better when we're together. It's always better when we're together. Look at them stars when we're together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. Just might find their way into my dreams tonight, but I know that they'll be gone
when the morning light sings or brings new things. For tomorrow night you see that they'll be gone too. Too many things I have to do. But if all of these dreams might find their way into my day-to-day scene, I'd be under the impression I was somewhere in between. With only two, just me and you, not so many things we got to do, or places we got to be. We'll sit beneath the mango tree now. Yeah, it's always better when we're together. We're somewhere in between together. Well, it's always better when we're together. Yeah, it's always better when we're together.
Okay, following the lightning line, the father of the bride, Mr. Joseph Mehta, please come to the dance floor and join your daughter. Fuerte los aplausos, señoras y señores, para el padre de la novia.
Yo creo que a todos los hombres les debe pasar lo mismo que cuando van a ser padres. Quisieran tener un niño, luego les nace una niña, sufren una decepción y después la quieren tanto y hasta cambian de opinión. Es mi niña bonita, con tu carita de rosa. Es mi niña bonita, cada día más preciosa. Es mi niña bonita, hecha de nardo y clavel. Es mi niña bonita, cuánto la llevo a querer. Si un día se casa mi niña, vestida de blanco armiño, recordaré que soñaba al Señor del gran poder, que el hombre que se la lleve la sepa siempre querer.
Once again, let's hear it for the bride and her father. Fuerte los aplausos para la novia y su papá. Gracias. Okay, following Kevin, would like to invite his mother, Mrs. Nelly Almarico, to the dance floor.
You taught me everything, and everything you've given me, I always keep it inside. You're the driving force in my life. Yeah, there isn't anything just wouldn't feel right if I didn't have you by my side. Oh, you were there for me to love and care for me when skies were gray. Whenever I was down, you were always there to comfort me. No one else can be what you have been to me. You will always be. You will always be the girl in my life for all time.
Mama, mama, you know my heart, your love.
Once again, let's give the girl Minnie's mom a big round of applause. Thank you. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, following, we will be toasting the bride and groom. This time we would like to invite Amalia and Chris.
Okay, so as you all know, my name is Amalia by now. Thank you for being here today, celebrating the holy matrimony of Madeline and Kevin. When I first met Madeline, we were just 7 years old in a second grade advanced Spanish program, and our friendship grew into a sisterhood. And over the years, we have laughed, cried, experienced the good and the bad times together. But one thing that has never changed is that our childhood fairy tales turn into adult dreams and accomplishments. I can assure you that today signifies everything Madeline ever dreamed of and more. Kevin came into Madeline's life as a true soulmate, and from day one, they have fulfilled time after time that love conquers it all. Their love has continuously been a proof that love bears all things, believes, hopes, endures, and that love does not fail. Today we witness the official seal of that promise of love. I wish them a marriage full of blessings, patience, understanding, and that their love continues to grow each and every day.
Handsome, charismatic, loving, kind, smart. But enough about Bean. Let's talk about Kevin for a little bit. I've known Kevin my whole life. There's a good photo on our grandmother's wall of me. He's laying down. My face is just above his ass. And I've been looking at that big ass my whole life. But his ass is not only big, it's smart as well. The favorite story that his whole side of the family, I'll explain to Madeline's now, is... We were younger. He picked up a cinder block as we were playing outside. And he threw it at me. And he hit me in the side of the face. Yeah, this guy. Thank God he hit me in the side of the face. Because if he didn't, the agility was going to whoop that big ass. But he's not only big ass. He's a smart as well. He's had a lot of smart ideas. One of them, well... Coolio's Gangster's Paradise was what I wanted to play, but he wanted to play Spice Girls in front of the house. We live next door to each other. Another smart idea was when he was in high school, he had an Acura Integra, and he put the biggest wing on that thing. I mean, it would fly in outer space. Exhaust on it. We put house speakers. We stole Uncle Michael's house speakers to put them in the back for more bass. Smart, smart things. But then he did get smart. You know, he became a doctor. And, you know, I love you for that. You've been a big inspiration to me. You know, I look up to you as my big brother. Well, I look down, but I look up to you as my big brother because he's a little shorter than me. But anyways, the smartest idea he ever had was when he came over and he told me about Madeline, that he wanted to marry her. And that's the best decision that I think he's going to make in his lifetime. And yeah, I want to wish them a lifetime of happiness. I think we all do. But I messed up. Let's give a round of applause for how good Madeline looks tonight. Madeline and her girls look fantastic tonight. Fantastic. So let's end this with a cheers. Everybody raise a glass. To a lifetime of happiness and success, I love you, bro. Good job.